Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dina Padalkina. I'm the founder of a Berlin-based association called Circular Berlin. And today I was invited to give you a short overview how we approach the topic of circular economy in construction, also within the project of CityLoops, where we also partner, and hope this will be also insightful for you and you could also take some learnings out of that. I will briefly also mention who we are. As an association, a non-for-profit organization, we have a mission to accelerate Berlin transitions towards the circular city, envisioning it as a resilient, citizen-oriented region. We have a big mission, so it's not only about construction sector, it's also about other activities and other industries in Berlin. And in this case, we do it through three main areas of work. One of them is a knowledge building, where we involved into four sectors, such as built environment, which is I'm leading, as well as the product and materials, food and biomass, textile and fashion. Another activity where we are very much engaged is the community building and as well education. So construction is a different industry. That's what I believe and say everyone who is all working with the topic of circular economy. Mainly because in construction industry, we make decisions that have an impact into the future. So what we build now will stay there after 60 years. This is current estimation of lifespan of average building in Europe. And this is, of course, a huge difference comparing to the something which like as a mobile phone or any other consumer good product, which stay there maybe up to 1 week till 2 years. This is something which we definitely have to consider in this sector when we make decisions how to build a new building. Another thing which is also very specific here is what we have now and what we will have in the future. Today also, it's very important to consider that Europe already has a gigantic building stock that is reaching the end of its life and is in need of renovation. This is actually also one of the strategies in the Green Deal of the European Commission to start an ambitious renovation wave in the construction sector. However, the concept of circular economy is also a new concept. And of course, we also will build new buildings. So the question is for tomorrow, how this novel concept for today's building make it for the future? How we can incorporate it as fast as possible into the buildings which will be realized in the next years. A circular building can be defined as follows. The design, construction, and demolition of a building in such a way that it incorporates not only the high value use and reuse of materials and an adaptive and future-proof design, but also ambitious for sustainability in relation to energy, water, biodiversity, and ecosystems at the building and area level. I believe it's a very ambitious definition, which actually we definitely need to keep in mind that it's not only about the building itself, it's about the values which are incorporated in the in this building already, but it's also about the system around the building, how the building can impact diverse systems, which goes beyond only construction sector. What we also use in our workshop and try to say that this is currently the most advanced approach to approach the topic circular economy in construction. We introduced six layers of building, which was designed or developed by Stuart Brands, where you can see the building across six layers, as I already said, site, structure, skin, services, space planning and stuff. Why these six layers are important? Because building as a product itself is quite a complex idea. And if we use the topic of circular economy, we need to consider the lifespan of it. So site in this case has it's a fixed location of the building, which has of course the longest lifespan, it's just there. Before construction and after construction. Structure or structural elements is a skeleton of the building, which can have lifespan from 30 to 300 years. Skin, which is usually a facade and all exteriors like windows or entering doors, have lifespan until it will be redesigned, maybe between 20, 30 years. Services, which includes some such elements as pipes, energy, heating systems, they might have the lifespan up to 30 years as well. Space plan, this is something which actually the most, one of the big changing elements in the building, which can be redesigned from 10 to 30 years each. And is basically in interior walls and interior design. And then we have also such elements as staff, that's all what we integrate into the interior of the space, like furnitures or lighting systems, lamps, and so on and so forth. We, in our workshop, we also use this element to approach circularity compass, and I will show how we've done it later. But how it all could be connected with an approach of circular economy, how we can also understand it through circularity compass. So in our workshop, we introduced it on example of the brick. And as you can see, that's how a circularity compass is usually represented. And on the level of material, it's a little bit easier to understand how it works, because in the very beginning, on the upper side, we talk about extraction of materials or minerals. So in this case, with the brick, we need clay, water, some supplements, which will be mixed together further. But before the mix, it will also need to be transported all together from different sources. As soon as they are transported all together, the production of the brick will start. So you need to mix clay, you need to make a shape of it. You probably will also dye it or color it with particular type of brick you need. Then you will fire it, and then finally you're going to package it for the next step. After the, so for example, you can see also here that arrows come into it, some external area, for example, packaging, which comes exactly on this stage. However, the other processes will come in through the normal stages of the life of the build, of the bricks production. Next step is a construction. So we have a brick, it's packaged, and it will be sent to the construction site. So through transportation, it will be also installed and mortared to the on the building. And after that, it will stay in the building. Let's say it will stay between 60 and 100 years. Brick is an element which does require high maintenance, so you will not need to do a lot of maintenance work with that. But we need to keep in mind that the brick which we produced maybe in the last year will stay in the building for next 60 years. Let's say it only we're talking about facade in this case. Then next step, it's coming to the demolition. So after the use of between 60 and 100 years, highly probably the demolition process of the building will start. In case of brick, it will be demolished together with other elements and other materials. So in the, right now, the disadvantage of the brick that you can't actually disassemble. So highly probably it will be crushed together with everything rest. Everything else, and will be transported to the landfill. So on this element, we will not be able to, or on this stage, we will not be able to come back with the brick to the primary raw materials, which were clay, water, for example, but it will leave the system on such level, probably to the landfill. This is a current situation of the material. However, our workshop, we thought we're going to go a bit more complex than the brick, and we designed two cases for our group to take a look on the buildings and also to take a look on two different type of buildings. So one building we discuss with our groups is a new construction of apartment housing, which is happening in Berlin. And it is example for the new building. So as I said, it's a housing, it's not a commercial building. And despite the fact, we thought, okay, it's already quite complex to take a look on one building. So we need actually to use six layers approach, which I introduced before. And for this particular example, we decided to take a look on facades only. So facade elements for the housing. And the question was, what kind of, so we didn't predefine anything about what kind of facade should be, what facade elements the participant should suggest, so everyone could design their own facade type. However, it was important to understand which material, if they decide on one or another facade, which material will come into this facade, how many of these materials will come into this. Then it was a question as well to understand how long this facade will be used, and how often it will be renovated, and what will happen with this facade actually at the end of the life. It's kind of the same view on the circularity compass, however, on the topic of facade, yes? And another case, which we also discussed with another group, it's a topic of redesign. So it means that the building is already there. However, due to any possible reasons. In this case, it was the new owner of the building appeared. It's also a real example in Berlin, where originally it was a shopping mall. However, the new plan for the building, it should become an office space. So in order to also to simplify the work for the our participants, we decided that we're going to talk here only on the space plan. So the what I also introduce you, it's one of the element for the six layers approaches. So this is what these were two cases which we targeted with our group, and I will briefly show you what we actually had a result here. It was interesting to see that based on the decision that they made in the very beginning, for example, which materials will come into facade, what type of facade it will be, what type of windows it will be. They quite quickly understood that sometimes they just don't know how it works. But this is what was very important with the circularity compass, to understand how we should make a decision beforehand, right? So recently, we decided with the team internally to visualize the results. Unfortunately, this information is not known in German, but I hope to explain what happened. So if you remember, the task was to take a look on the facade element for the housing. And the team decided that they're going to do the facade out of wood element. The insulation element will be done out of straw, and windows should be made out of glass and aluminium. And for balcon, they decided to use recycled concrete in this case. The conclusion were that, okay, after constructing each of these elements in the very beginning, already after 40 years, the new modernization of the building, of the facade, probably will appear. A lot of these materials, which were already in planning right now, they will probably reach end of life. Especially, it was a discussion for the external layer of facade. Also, probably for particular elements for the windows. As well, the assumption was that some windows will be turned into balconies. That's where you can see that some windows element will reduce the amount, but they will have new balcon elements. So what it means that some of these ideas or some of these elements, after 40 years, even though they are still usable elements, will probably, highly probably, will end their lives. In terms of insulation, highly probably it will still will be there. However, new insulation layer probably will be added to this. We also discuss what can happen with this scenarios for end of life for each of these elements in facade. And you can see that a lot of this actually go to recycle. However, recycling of this could be also going into thermal recycling, so energy, burning for energy production. Some of the elements could be recycled back into the industries, like, for example, glass from the windows, or recycled concrete could be also further recycled for the same industry. However, the working group was also very ambitious, keeping in mind that decision was made to make, for example, aluminium frames for the window, that aluminium frame could be again reused as a frame for another window. As well as facade elements, the idea was the one that will be taken out from the facade layer, they could be still reused for the further wood construction after it will be properly treated. With another building, it was quite interesting discussion as well. So the one which is already there, mainly we use the same approach. So we first trying to understand what is already there. And what is interesting was in debates for the building which is already constructed and it will be redesigned, is to understand what is actually use phase of in circularity compass. Because it's kind of already constructed building, so it means it's already in use phase. However, we need to keep in mind that for redesign approach, we actually talk about the use phase of the new building, so the one which will be redesigned. And this was one of the challenging idea to understand it. Where is actually the use? What happened? I mean, right now it's still already the building. So we're dealing actually already with a constructed building, and where which phase happening here, it was a little bit complicated, but we managed it. So after that, we also approached the idea of what business models could be done here. And interesting what happened. When we try to understand which materials coming into the, or which materials already there and components already there in a shopping mall for the only space element, so we talk only about space, it was quite clear that we're mainly talking about the floor and the interior walls. That's why we focus here only on two elements here. For floor, as the shopping mall right now, we actually have diverse types of floor elements. So the team decided that we only will talk about wooden floor or timber floor and some kind of carpets which are there. For the walls, which interior walls are there, it's a normal drywalls there with probably some aluminium frame inside to separate it, but also some glass walls. Interesting part which we discuss here, so whenever you would do this redesign phase, and this is what we started here with, this is a time frame for the building being before it is redesigned. So everything what comes here is how it was. And this is a time frame when it's now redesigned. So this is 20 years when it's now redesigned. And the interesting part was here that quite often team noticed, interesting, we actually in this redesign phase, we take a lot of the elements which are in the building and we build in exactly the same elements just because it requires new redesign plan. Especially it was quite astonishing for the wall elements. It meaning that a lot of interior walls, it meant we have to take them out and construct them new. And quite often we discuss actually they are quite standardized elements, but they're just not possible to disassemble or take them out or and reuse in the same building. So they're not designed for that. That's why quite often they are actually will be ripped out. And interesting that in this use phase, we ask how often, how long this office space will actually exist. And for the space plan, we decided, okay, let's say it will be 20 years plan. It means after 20 years plan, the walls here, they will be probably again taken out from the system. However, they haven't reached the end of life. Basically, when we do redesign of the building, a lot of interior components will be taken out, and exactly the same components, maybe a little bit upgraded with the time, will be incorporated again, which produce a lot of waste. And again, here on that level, it was quite difficult to incorporate the topic of reuse, mainly because most of the elements, they are not made to be disassembled. So mainly the strategies which are which we discussed, it was recycling of the elements, and some of them it's also possible, but will be through waste to energy approach done. However, some of them it's possible to maybe to recycle to the same industries, so the glass element. So the main outcome here was, if we use interior elements in the building, that highly probably after 20 years will be again redesigned, we need to use them that way that it's possible to disassemble them and reassemble them, because they are actually kept in the same way. This is what's my current learnings of our two workshops. I hope it was insightful for you. And if you have any further questions, please let me know. I wish you a nice rest of the workshop.